guys, so this is my finished Archer shirt, and the pattern is from Grainline Studio. I just wanted to give some quick notes about the pattern, like what I did. I guess there's not a whole lot that I have to say about the pattern itself. So the fabric that I used is Robert Kaufman, it's a chambray, and it's like polka dotted. It's this really nice maroon color, and I actually made it for my capsule wardrobe, which you'll hear me talk about a lot. Anyway, so I am really excited about this shirt, actually. I'm a huge fan of just like pretty casual button-ups like this. I really like the color. The fabric is pretty nice. It's 100% cotton, I'm fairly certain. And I don't think I've ever got Robert Kaufman fabrics before, although I know they're really, really popular. And I like it. I got it from a local fabric store. So I used a polyester thread that I just went and picked up at Michael's one night, because I actually forgot to get matching thread whenever I bought this fabric, which, rookie mistake, I know, but yeah. So the stitching doesn't match exactly. Like, I would prefer it to be a bit of a darker red, and you can kind of tell more like in the buttonholes, with the buttonholes, that they're kind of a light red compared to the shirt. But I still like it. The buttons are like a fake shell look. I can tell they're plastic because they're thicker than a normal shell, and they're like, I don't know, you can feel that it's plastic. I was actually able to put this shirt together pretty quickly, and I think that the reason why I was able to do that pretty quickly is because of my dress, the Art Alder shirt dress that I made. If I'm pronouncing that wrong, by the way, tell me, because I realize that I might be saying that wrong, but I don't know. Anyway, the Alder shirt dress, you know what I'm talking about? That was the first time I've made a collar that I've actually been okay with how it looks. And then this time, I remembered what I did wrong before, and so it was that much easier. And so that's like the nice thing about sewing. Whenever you make one mistake, as long as you remember it, you won't make it again. And so yeah, I feel like I learned a lot from making that dress. So this one went together pretty quickly. One thing I will say that I messed up, I guess it's a mess up. So I was having a lot of trouble printing out the digital pattern that I got. I should make a video on digital patterns sometime, because I've gotten more experience with them now. I was going to print them out at work because I don't own a printer. And we have like a new printing system at work, and it just doesn't work very well, to be completely honest. And so I ended up just canceling the printing job, and I went across the street to go print it at Staples, because there's one really close to my work. And I was like trying to do it. It took me forever to just figure out how to get the printer to work at Staples, and then I realized it didn't let you print it so that it was scaled 100%, because the pattern is actually scaled down so that it can fit on like European size paper or something. I don't know exactly. I think that's what it is. But basically, you need to print it out at 100% scale rather than have it auto fit to the page. And they couldn't do that with the printing that I was or like a printer I was trying to use. So, and I didn't want to wait, so I just decided to come to my apartment complex, the business center, and tried to print it out there. And I thought it was all fine. I had it at 100% scale, and I printed out like all 40 pages or something. And then I got back to my place, and then I actually measured the square, and it was supposed to be 3 inches, and it was 3 inches and 1/8. And I was like, I don't even care. I'm just gonna go with it. And I did the math, and it's like, every 24 inches, I'll have an extra inch, so the pattern sizing is a little off, admittedly, but I honestly could not be bothered to try to print it out again after that fiasco. So that was a that was a fun time, obviously. So yeah, after that I was able to actually put together my pattern, and it turned out pretty good. I should have sized down, knowing that that my pattern was a little bit messed up, but I think it worked out okay. I'm fine with oversized shirts. I don't like things that are too small, but if it's a little bit too big, I'm okay with it. Another thing that I did incorrectly was I put the sleeves on the wrong side. So like this sleeve was on this side and this, and like, I don't know, that was just a small detail I wasn't paying attention to. But then whenever I actually tried on the shirt, like it seemed a little bit weird. The sleeves seemed really like big and parachute-y for some reason. And I was so confused why. I was like, I guess I made it too big, so that's what happened because of the pattern sizing issue. But then I hung it up in my closet with all the other button-ups that I have, and then like the next day I was looking at my clothes for work, trying to pick out what to wear, and I looked at the sleeves and I realized that the cuffs were going the same way on all of my shirts except for this one. And then I realized I needed to fix that. And that fix was not too big of a deal. It took me maybe an hour to actually seam rip everything and put it back together. I did do French seams, as I always do, and I think the collar looks pretty good, all things considered. The pockets, one of them is matched up really nicely, and the other one is not. I probably could cut out some extra fabric to make it match, but I didn't even bother. I think it looks fine how it is. You can't really notice. If it was something bigger, you would probably be able to notice more, like if it was a big stripe, or even if it was plaid, it might be easier to notice. But even then, I would probably do like cut it on the bias so it was like a diagonal plaid. But yeah, I really like this pattern. Might try making some more, but I will probably print it out again if I do, so that it's actually the right size. But otherwise, it looks pretty good. So yeah, that's what it looks like buttoned up all the way. And I really like it. I think it'll look cute with sweaters. And I have all these things planned out with my capsule wardrobe that I'm so excited for. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you later. Bye!